All right. But this is a good style of or understanding who you are, what you do, how you do it. Everyone talks about nutrition like there's an end all be all, right? Every single person, every individual is different, right? What you're doing, your activity level, your job, how much sleep you get, right? With the style of training that you do. All these things need to be factored into how you eat and then just how your body adapts, right? Like, for instance, you know, we got to think about the amount of calories that we eat first and foremost, right? How many calories should you eat? If you don't know that, it's pretty easy. I'll break it down for you after class. We'll give you the formula. It'll take you 2 seconds. And that gives you a generalization of, you know, how many calories throughout the day you should eat. If you're trying to gain weight, obviously you're in a surplus. If you're trying to decrease weight, you have to have less calories coming in than the calories coming out, right? So the activity level's got to go up, the calories coming in got to go down, period. But the common mistake there is plenty of people will undereat, right? Undereating is also bad, guys, because your body, to survive, needs sugar. So what's it going to use if it runs out of calories and runs out of sugar, natural sugar? Your muscle, right? Then there goes your metabolism, you know, working at a fast pace. There goes exactly what you guys are trying to do, which is build bone density, prevent your bones from breaking, make your t-shirts look better naked, you know what I'm saying? So if you start utilizing the muscle, then it's, you know, it's no good, obviously. So pay attention. Stay with me. Pay attention. Nutrients, all right? Guys, listen up. Nutrients, right? Carbohydrates. Everyone says don't eat carbs. For who? When? You know, if you're someone who burns 3,000 calories throughout the day, you know, doing high-level labor at work, you know, and you're burning 1,500, 2,000 calories just at work, you better be getting some sort of fuel into your body. Think nutrients, right? Not a certain food. And then if you come and you train your ass off and you're a beast in the gym, you better be getting glycogen stores. You better be getting secondary sugars that your body can help to recover to build that muscle, right? So when you eat the carbohydrates is very important. What type of carbohydrates you eat. Remember, fruits are carbohydrates, grains are carbohydrates, sweet potatoes are a better choice, right? Wheat bread is a better choice. Brown rice, better choice. But, you know, don't go and eat 3 pieces of brown, you know, of wheat bread and just because it's wheat bread, right? So, you know, that fine line. But you got to fuel your body, right? Also, what's important when you're thinking about nutrition, water. You know, I'll tell you right now, if half my clients would drink more water, the nutrition would be a lot better, period. Half your body weight in fluid ounces, too. I hear people all the time, and I'm a victim of it. You know, I'll tell myself that I drank water, I had 4 bottles of water. I'm 195 pounds right now, you know? 4 bottles of water is nothing to me. You know what I'm saying? 8, 9, 10 bottles of water, depending on who you are. When you eat, we just talked about sleeping, very important. You know, that's the second thing to nutrition. Most people don't get enough sleep. All right, if you sleep 6 to 8 hours a night, you work harder at it, you get to bed on time, you start eliminating things, making your room darker, you know, your body's gonna recover better. Your metabolism, therefore, is going to speed up. You're gonna want less sugar throughout the day. That's science. That's not like maybe. That's science. You don't get enough sleep, you want more sugar. That's the way your hormones work. All right, so now, depending on the person, who you are, when you train, right? And if you're not sure, we can talk after class or whatever. But 5 meals a day, you know, people say 5 to 6 meals a day, you know, every 2 to 5 hours or whatever. That's fine, it just depends. Have you tried it? Does it work for you? What happens when you do it? Did you try it for 1 day and it didn't work, or it did work, so now you do it, right? Or 3 months, or 5 months. Have you tried the training that you're doing with the style of eating that you're doing? All those things need to be factored before you make your decision on how you eat and when you eat. So 5 feedings, if you're doing this one, you're doing feedings. Not meals. So let's say you want, you know, 2,000 calories, guys, right? Then each one, I'm no math wizard, but, you know, blah, 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 right? So it'd be whatever, 600, 500, whatever, the amount of calories here, okay? If you want, if you're eating 2,000 calories and you're eating 3 meals a day, right, now you have to factor those calories into each meal, right? And if you're using a lot of energy throughout the day, maybe you're doing your carbohydrates here, and maybe not at night, or maybe carbs make you feel better, so you eat them at night and during the day, and maybe not in the morning, okay? Or what I do, okay? Because I get home at 9:30 at night, and then that's when I eat. So I have a husky stir fry at night 5 times a week. We have pizza on Fridays. 5 times a week, you know, husky stir fry here. And then 11 a.m., I have eggs, broccoli, spinach, avocado, right? Makes sense? So what am I getting here? Nutrients, right? Protein. Carbs, right? Fats, all good stuff. So it depends. You know, people say calories are the enemy. Calories aren't the enemy. Nutrient-dense meals. How many you eat are up to you. How your blood sugar works. It's all independent, right? Figure out your style. And the ways in which you're picking your style is, are you doing good in the gym? Are you getting sick, right? Can you sleep at night? What does your body look like? How long are you able to train hard for? How long throughout the week does it take you to recover? Can you train hard for 3 weeks and then fall off for three, right? That factors into your diet, okay? And look, if you're someone who doesn't eat that much and then binges at night, obviously you gotta change up your style, man. You're setting yourself up for failure, all right? So if anybody has any questions on this, just let me know, all right? But I figured maybe, you know, that would help you out.
Thank you.